get Otto and George to join the party here. Otto and George, want to explain Otto and George to the new listeners, Anthony? I mean the faithful listeners of the program.
Filthy ventriloquist.
Exactly. Otto and the and George the puppet in his New York Yankee outfit.
I got my cup of coffee because I suck in the morning. Hey, a shot and a beer, you fucking homo. Let me get these on first.
Got to talk to George there.
There you go.
Thank you. How you doing? Hi, Rich.
Very good.
How are you, Bonnie?
That's Bonnie. Yeah, you
heard everyone. Otto, what's up, man?
I was just about to explain your DVD, Otto.
Yeah.
Classic Moments, Volume 1, Otto and George. I've been waiting for something like this to come out.
Everything's on there but me making big money.
You got your first appearance on our show.
Yeah.
And also we did the Joe Franklin show.
Yes,
Joe
my Franklin. Friends.
That's on there.
My friends.
Wow.
Martin Paints. Martin Paints, my friend.
Your Morton Downey Jr. appearance.
Yeah, dead.
Yes,
very dead.
Long dead.
Very dead.
Playboy Channel. Howard Stern, you cover it all. Your whole
career.
All right,
let's get out
of
here. There's a lot of pussy outside. I got to talk to these pasty fucks. The radio fucks.
What's wrong with you, George?
He's all right.
He's all right? Okay.
Hey, is that a true story about the Puerto Rican stabbing the dummy?
Yeah, that happened. Central Park. Stabbed the puppet.
And then without...
Didn't like what he was saying?
Yeah, I guess. I mean, you know, probably.
Must have been something about Puerto Ricans, though, I would gather.
I don't think I was that rough on him.
Really?
He was hallucinating or something, yeah.
You remember the joke you told that got this guy so pissed he ran
probably,
on stage
George
for the night?
Probably said, you're ugly, and then I said, tell him you're sorry, and he said, I'm sorry, you're ugly. It was very light and tame for those days.
Right.
That nigga! No, I'm sorry.
Jesus.
After he stabbed you without missing a beat, didn't the dummy go, the spick stab me?
Yeah. Yeah.
He stabbed the puppet. He was so pissed off.
That's something.
The illusion is intact.
But it didn't hurt him. That's nice.
No, I got a scar here on this knuckle
pulled
here.
Through.
Oh, yeah. It went right through to where it hit you.
Yeah.
Wow.
Got a scar.
They got battle scars.
That's pretty cool.
So, George, did you see the new Honeymooners movie?
Uh-oh.
Fuck Cedric the Circus Ape. That fucking reject from the Samsonite commercial. A fucking monkey with a SAG card died.
Oh, God. Oh, boy.
Oh, my God.
The puppet, I guess, did not like the Honeymooners.
Wow. What is that bullshit?
It did horrible at the box office, and we couldn't be happier.
The fuck is this guy?
All right. That's relax.
Chugging coffee in the waiting room, you got this fuck on the air.
All right.
It's a football player. Be nice. This guy could put a buffalo in a headlock. I ain't scared of you. I'll fucking hit you with the D-train.
That's Tyson Walter, George. He plays with the Dallas Cowboys.
Nice to meet you.
Who gives a shit?
Dallas Cowboys.
The puppet is surly this morning.
He is very surly.
Oh, by the way, Rich was talking about your TV appearance, and you were billed as your first and last name.
Yeah,
you're
Greg
right.
Hughes
it should be Opie and Anthony.
Yeah.
You know, it's
yeah, we did notice
that. Well, now that you did
but we didn't do it.
Well, now you did Bravo. Do you think maybe you could do, like, the Best in the 90s on VH1 or one of those?
We did that already.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Well,
Dick.
You guys.
I'm
coming.
Yeah, it was Jesus. Weird because you guys were doing, like, you loved, like, female.
Well,
we're just hacks.
Female here.
We're awful hacks.
What are you
really
doing?
Are.
Sheena, you thought was pretty cool.
What are you doing?
Yeah.
Grapple Network.
We,
yeah.
I had no business being on that show.
It is really awful.
They ask you to do it,
they
and you're like, yeah,
it.
We like
no, it's like it always goes with people talking us into shit. They're like, oh, this will be really good, you know, to get the name out there and the station you're on. You know, not a lot of people know you're on XM at this point. It'll be nice to get the...
And they always say, you're going to find a new audience.
Yeah, it's great. Audience. And then we go, you know, okay, we'll do it. We get there and go, oh, this is just going to be bad. Okay, tell us something about a superhero girl that you think... I don't know any of this shit. Mom.
Yeah,
fake it.
You look squeezed in there too. Like
oh, they pop
had
it. We're together so tight, and they go, "Could you guys get a little closer? We're trying to get you in
never
frame."
Said anything.
That's how it
you
starts.
That's how it starts, and then we're jerking off each other.
Yeah. Anthony and I have been doing radio over 10 years. We've barely touched each other.
We
barely.
Hate getting close
we,
to
I think
each
we
other.
Give each other, I was going to say, a fist every once in a while.
Yeah, you know, a little lard.
Fist, right? A little lard and
a little
glove.
Fist.
Right, okay. Sure. Who's looking? I said a lot, but I had nothing to say about superheroes. I was goofing on everything else, and obviously that's not what the show is about.
I don't know that to crap. Know a little bit about everything, and Now, of course, I could just bullshit my way through those things, but... And then you watch back and you're like, okay, this is a great move. Yeah, great career move. Fucking beautiful.
You could fly, like right in here, this is, you know, your home, this is where you're supposed to be. You could fly through the channels and just fly right past you two guys and go, DJs.
Right, exactly, yeah. Right? I know. DJs, yeah, no shit.
Gee, thanks. We'll worry. Thanks, Rich, as we're trying to get away from the...
At least they got jobs, though. I see people on those shows, like the 90s shows and stuff. It's like, this person doesn't even fucking work.
Well,
yeah.
We
That's
had a
their
meeting
job.
With Comedy Central, and and the person that at Comedy Central that's in charge... One of the people that's in charge of our pilot, one day I'm flipping through in Comedy Central... It was like some dumb... you know, stand-up show, like, I can't remember what it was.
Sit down, stand up.
Some where they have, like, you know, five different comics on or whatever, yeah. And the executive is on doing stand-up on the show.
Kind of takes away from his executiveness.
Yeah. No, it was a chick.
Oh. Hey,
Anthony,
oh, I said his. Instantly thinking the executive's got to be the man.
Of course.
No, in TV,
That's
they're
how
all
we
ladies.
Think Go get some coffee for the men.
Anthony, I got some examples of our appearance on Bravo.
You do?
We might as well let these guys smash us today.
Oh, here we
this
go.
This is something we've been avoiding. Like, we knew we were on this show, and everyone's like, hey, when are you guys going to talk about your appearance on Bravo? And we make believe we don't read the email or the instant feedback or the phone calls coming in.
I was on the toilet. You're still on Bravo.
I forgot until I was in bed on a Sunday night, and I just turned on the TV real fast. I'm like, oh, that's right. We
what
did that
words
like 6 months
of wisdom
ago.
That people cannot possibly live without did we spew out on this show.
Here's Anthony talking about Blade.
Blade also reflected classic Marvel Comics archetype, the anti-hero, whose special powers are also a curse.
He doesn't quite belong to either the humans or the vampires, so he's in constant battle with each of them, plus internally in himself. That adds a lot to the storyline. And it's cool, and it gives him a lot of people to kick ass.
Did you hear me in that clip? I went,
what the fuck did he say? During every pause, did you go, I'm not saying anything funny right here?
Yeah.
You just kept pausing.
This is it. Nothing funny going on. Nothing funny.
My job, which was pointed out by the listeners, was to look at Anthony lovingly through
I said, Obi just turned and was looking lovingly.
And nodding.
Nodding.
I had the look of love in my eye that the asshole listeners told me.
And when you're doing those shows, too, no matter what you say, they're always sitting there going, great, funny stuff.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. Oh, that's great.
It's great. Clever little sound bites are nice, but nothing's better than cracking somebody's spine in half, right there, Dallas? Fucking sadist.
George, you're nuts, man. He's five times your size.
On his coffee.
Yeah.
He is very big, George. Yeah. Got a pick on him. Whatever.
All right, well, here's Ant on Princess Leia.
Oh,
maybe I get a word in this time.
Oh, okay, let's listen for what Opie has.
The first clip, I heard the start of
It was every young boy's fantasy to see Princess Leia in a little slinky leather thing and chains. She got her justice for Jabba the Hutt degrading her like that. That was cool. Good to watch.
I know a little too much about that shit.
That was your own personal anger coming out.
Yeah.
She got what was due.
Yeah, yeah. Jabba the Hutt got it. Good. Good for him.
Yeah, I don't know, but if you know about the time where I put money in the bank.
I am quite a faggot. Jesus Christ.
All others were circle jerking.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
We
would
Princess
get
Leia.
Together and jack off to Star Wars movies.
Otto, did you like Princess Leia? George,
no.
Anyone? No?
She wasn't hot at all. I never cared for the Star Wars movies, really.
Yeah?
Nah.
Nah.
Have you seen the new one? The new one's pretty cool.
I think Lucas is doing fine without your $9.
Right? Right? I know. I'd like to see him do another American Graffiti, you know, just do something
about something
people,
different.
You know?
Something good. Right. About real people.
Yeah.
Yeah. Guy's got
nine
nothing.
Bucks.
Well, this clip says O and A on Princess Leia, so I might get a little time here.
There was more to say, huh?
She is the only character in Star Wars who hits every target she shoots at. There's a little Star Wars nerdy trivia for you. Kind of bitchy,
great
though.
Great hairdo.
What?
Kind of bitchy.
Snotty.
Talking about Jimmy.
Kind of bitchy. There
were you
go.
Talking about Princess Leia or Jimmy Norton? Did you call her a fuckface?
Kind of bitchy. All right. There you go.
Kind of bitchy.
That's what I give everybody.
That's Opie's contribution.
Well,
kind of
bitchy. Get XM after this appearance. Right. Oh, they're probably lining up at satellite.
Right, running out of equipment.
Who are those two guys who are on Bravo? They were kind of bitchy.
Lining up around the block at the Best Buy.
We suck.
All right. Well, here's O and A on Xena.
I think as a teenager, you had the fantasy of a woman that knew what she was doing, would take charge, and Xena definitely filled that bill. Had her little Amazon woman scream, whatever that was. Kind of scary.
You ended everything with kind of cool, kind of scary.
Kind of cool, kind of gay. I suck.
Kind of neat.
Oh, is that awful? God, kind of awful. Kind of cool. Yeah, you're right. Oh, what a crutch-using ass.
And our final clip on.
Oh, there's another one? Let's hear what I say, kind of, at the end. Oh, no.
I've walked out of auditions knowing I really stink at this. Yeah. I'm really bad. You guys could not have walked out of there going, that we killed.
That went really well.
You know what? No, I got it. It was a who cares appearance. We didn't kill, obviously, but we didn't stink. It was who cares.
Like, well, it went.
And the funny thing is, we sat after this radio show for two and a half hours. Oh, easily, right, Ann?
Yeah.
The whole time with the camera rolling, I'm counting up our time on TV, 40 seconds, 50. That would, a minute 10. We got a minute 10 FaceTime out of 2.5 hours.
What you guys did as radio personalities and as funny guys, Clem the spot welder could have done what you two did.
Right.
They could have went down the hall and said, hey, put your bucket down. Yeah. We want you to come in here and talk about Princess Leia. Because these two stiffs have
nothing
funny to say.
What does a spot welder need a bucket?
Did they give you someone else information about it, all the people?
In advance?
Not really.
No. It's kind of...
You just had to off the top of your head.
Yeah, jeez.
Well, John brings up a good point on the phones. Go ahead, John.
Fuck John on the phone, asshole.
George, they're our listeners. We love them.
Fuck them all. Die screaming with a cock in her ass.
Hey, Opie, you were a teenager when Xena was on the air? You keep getting younger and younger. You were a teenager when Angie Dickinson was on the air.
Angie Dickinson. All right, John, don't blow my spot.
Yeah, policewoman.
Here's our final clip. This is Anthony talking about Catwoman.
Oh. Catwoman on all fours. A little, a little clawing across the chest, stuff like that. Sure.
That's it?
That's it.
Brilliant.
That was worth wasting 2.5 hours of our day.
Wow.
Hearing that twice is a delicious torture.
The worst.
Well, we finally got to that, huh, Ant?
Oh. And they're going to rerun that forever.
The Monday that we did the show, everyone's just like calling and emailing, and
we'll
just
never
like, oh,
get
that
away
thing.
From that.
No, we're too busy to get to that.
What's going
to
happen is Norton's going to become a big TV star.
Yeah.
He's going to be sitting around with a bunch of friends at a party or something, and a rerun's going to come on. And they're going to go to Norton, aren't those the guys you're on the radio? And, oh, I've never met them in my life.
Remember those coattails you rode to greatness, and then you jumped off just in time? Wow. 6 months from now, Jimmy Norton will not be on this show.
Now, I had a good talk with him the last time I was here. We walked to the car, and he was saying how he hates acting, you know, because I congratulated him on the HBO thing and stuff.
Yeah.
And he said, I hate acting. I love radio. This is where I'm, you know, most comfortable.
When they start throwing huge money at him. He did a great job on Leno last night. It was amazing.
I think he's going to make every effort to be here as often as he. I really
do.
Yeah.
So.
Really.
I don't know.
Note to self, don't call him a fuckface anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah, no more on-air arguments with him.
Yeah.
Got to coddle that boy. A waste.
Nah, he's a loyal friend. He always has been. So he'll do what he can.
Yeah, what's he? Yeah.
Hey, Michael Jackson.
Ah,
everyone's talking about Michael Jackson today.
Acquitted.
But we said 2 months ago that he would be acquitted. And
let everybody go. Colin Ferguson, let them all out. We'll kill everybody.
O.J.
Yeah.
Yeah, O.J.
Jack the Ripper.
O.J. obviously killed his wife and her gentleman friend there. And you open up the paper today. There he is with two broads on him at some bar, some party. He's still going to, like, parties, and he's invited to parties. And he's going out with a girl. One of the girls looked exactly like Nicole. Exactly.
Yeah, before or after.
Well, unfortunately, before. Whore.
It's That's what OJ's like. That's why he was out partying. He's going, wow, fuck, they're not going to talk about me for a month now.
Yeah, yeah, I'm off the hook. Michael Jackson thing, yeah.
Michael Jackson is going to... He's going to have a special. He's going to fuck a kid on TV and get away with it. That's going to be his next special.
Yeah, that's
CBS, primetime, Michael Jackson fucks a kid.
He's going to take it to the next level. He just wants us to...
It's beautiful.
What,
yeah.
What I don't understand is, too, and I'm watching... I watched this trial
everything?
One day.
Oh, sorry.
Well, no, it's, is people, like, okay, you guys have... People flew in from all over. Quit their job. I mean, they are fans. Uh-huh. They're sitting,
yeah.
I mean,
they're you starstruck.
You
yeah.
can't be that much of a fan. Like, they're sitting outside going, you know, we love you. It was his fault, the way he was, whatever. You're like, listen, how can you be that much of a fan? I like golf, like I was saying. I like Tiger Woods. If he gets hit by lightning or goes to prison, I'm an Ernie Els fan. You know what I'm saying?
He'll move on.
Who cares that much to go there every day and sit outside?
Lunatic mental patients. They're all fucked up in the head. None of them are.
Yeah.
It's not a normal person going, well, I'm just throwing my support behind this gentleman who I feel is innocent. It's always like, I have loved Michael for so many years. It's the flamboyantly gay guys and girls that are too fat and ugly to get any men. That's pretty much all I saw out there.
Did you see Dove Lady?
No. Which one's this?
Oh, this was lunatic lady. She was
releasing
a dove for every count that was he was
every
count on.
Oh,
a whole cage of friggin' doves.
Isn't that illegal?
You would think it should be.
You can't just release doves.
You can't do that.
He gets put in jail.
We're going to see Michael out there.
Yeah.
The doves.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? They can release a little boy every month.
Yeah,
a fucking dove. Let a kid run.
Run away.
Run away.
That's the...
He has just got, right now, though, he's got carte blanche now. I mean, they brought him up on these charges, acquitted. Twice they tried to get him on this. He paid off a family years ago. Mm-hmm. They just cannot catch him.
Yeah.
Yep.
I mean, it's supposed to be a jury of his peers. Who's his peers? Nobody's like this guy.
Yeah.
You know?
What peers? Yeah. Look in there. They have to bring him in from outer space. A representative from Jupiter? How do you find Michael Jackson?
You know, right when when it was no guilty, 6 feet of dirt flew open and Johnny Cochran's coffin popped. Get the fuck out of here.
If the coffin fits, you must be dead. Oh, sugar.
We got audio of the Dove Lady. Let's take a listen to this.
Great. Well, he's such a dear person to me and to lots of his fans. He's so innocent, and it was so sad to see him being taken advantage and being so misunderstood.
Oh, you sick God. Zombie cunt!
Shut up!
Let's play Guess What Drug She's On.
Jesus.
With that slurry voice.
Innocent. How does she know?
Yeah.
How the hell does she know? And him being acquitted of the charges just means that the prosecution didn't have enough evidence. This motherfucker is so guilty of at least jerking off in a bed like boss of his friends with young boys.
I jerked off to the footage of Carl Willenda falling to his death in Puerto Rico. Is there anything wrong with that?
That's hot. That was some hot footage.
Hey, did George jerk off to anybody?
Of course not.
Yeah. He's looking around. No, okay.
Here's the thing, too. The kid, I don't know how old the kid was, he's innocent. There's 1,000 people outside applauding. Yay. You got away with fucking this kid.
Yeah, he got away with it.
This kid has got to walk out of there going, they're all cheering. My ass reaming.
The bottom line is he sleeps with children. He's admitted to that.
Yeah.
I mean, they're applauding this guy.
Don't you think there's a chance that he might be what he says he is, just this guy who has sleepovers?
No.
You don't think there's any chance of that
no
at all?
No chance whatsoever. No.
He should be persecuted just for his face.
Yeah.
Why?
If Lawrence Taylor had kids sleeping over, he'd be in prison.
Anyone else. If you have children sleeping over, there's a problem. Michael Jackson, because he's got this Peter Pan complex, I didn't have a childhood, so I'm living it now. Stop it.
Yeah.
Why would you have kids around?
Let's go to George in Kansas City.
Fuck George in Kansas City. Shirk off.
George?
George, George the puppet doesn't like you. George.
Aha. Uh-huh.
George, Kansas City? No, you? Anybody?
Jew hater.
All right, he wants to compliment Bonnie. That's why I wanted to get this on the air today. Oh. Likes female point of view with Bonnie.
Oh, maybe we ought to have a woman on the show.
Female.
Chime in every so often and go, oh, guys.
She's not that type of woman.
No,
thank God.
Of course not.
That's why we like her.
That's a bit vulgar, fellas.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you guys done enough of that dumb morning radio where you see the stupid chick that has to be the buzzkill for everybody.
Oh, they hate him. He walks in, he goes, "Who's the skirt?"
Yeah, and she wants the respect.
And that's what the guys in the studio want to say, but they can't because the stupid management, you know, got them all together to do this show.
Oh,
we hate the female co-host. Hate.
What's in the news today? Well, enough.
Yeah.
Stop it.
Shoddy talk radio. Let's go on radio and talk.
What we're doing, though.
Wow. Why didn't the prosecutor say,
"Shoddy"?
Say, okay, do you own a monkey?
Yeah.
Do you have a Ferris wheel? Did you buy the bones of the elephant man? I rest my case.
Yeah.
That's it.
Guilty.
Guilty.
All right, let's play more from Dove Lady.
Absolutely, absolutely. Unfortunately, when you have fame and money, people do take advantage of you. And on the top of that, when you have a great, good heart, yes, that would be the number one goal for people to go after.
Huh?
What is it? Oh, yes, that's what people want to do. They want to get people with a good heart.
Yeah.
Get them.
Yeah, that's it. Get that good
go
person.
Go get them. Yeah. Go get them.
What is that vague accent she has? That,
yeah, it's you know, something going on there.
The only connection she has with him is she cleaned his hotel room one morning.
Yeah.
That's the accent of Oxycontin. Let's see.
She almost took one of the dove's heads off. Did you see that?
No.
She's releasing the doves and with every count, and one flies out, and then she's got to shut the lid real quick, because if two fly out during one count, she's got to kill herself or something. So she goes to, like, smash the cage door down. One of the doves are trying to get out. Its head got stuck. It's great. I was hoping to just see it snap its little dove neck, little dove blood coming out its beak.
That's hilarious. It would ruin her world.
Oh, totally would ruin it.
What do I do? Two doves got out. Gotta kill my son.
If he was guilty and she had to go home with nine doves, it's like me leaving a gig with all my DVDs back in the suitcase. Oh, Jesus. And now you know what it's like. These DVDs are doves.
Didn't work out.
By the way, Otto and George will be selling their DVD.
Yeah. Yes.
At your shows, I guess, right?
Yeah.
Well, you got to get a link on a website or something. We could sell you a ton of these things through our website easily.
Okay. Really?
Yeah, talk to Steve after
you
after
don't have
show.
A website? Oh, over here.
What?
Oh. You don't have a website?
Yeah, I do somewhere.
You
but
do?
I don't. I don't run it myself.
No?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I got an electric can opener recently. Because
all right. You're getting there. That's cool.
I rest my balls on top of it.
Vibrates. Yeah, people jerking off with appliances.
That's what I did with the weed whacker. It worked fine for me. You could sell a ton of these if you're on a website, Otto.
What makes you think I don't? Oh, on
even
the website?
Even more.
Well.
Just our faithful listeners all over the country would, you know, that aren't going to go see you because you're not coming to their town would buy this thing.
Really?
Yeah, you got to get to with Steve. Hey, we'll figure something out.
I got
for
that
you.
Fucking speech, too. Four DVDs.
Yeah.
All right. Four DVDs. If I would have made a Bravo appearance, I might have made it up to six.
Oh, yeah. True.
Got more doves in my house.
All right. Speaking of which, we have a couple more clips from Dove Lady.
You know, we all have a child within ourselves, and he really missed his childhood. And in our culture, Middle East, Far East, this is really not abnormal.
Is
there's nothing
Dr.
wrong with
vibes?
That.
Middle East.
He perhaps doesn't want to grow
not
up.
A problem sawing
and
people's
that is what
heads
he
off.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that. And the way he has always shown his love to people.
The Jew is poisoning the planet.
The problem isn't, and the case wasn't about him having a child within him. It's him within the child. Oh, stop it.
I think this guy, Chuck, makes a good point. Chuck?
Hey, what's going on?
What's up?
Hey, Michael Jackson's got this whole Peter Pan complex thing going on because he didn't have a childhood as a kid.
Yeah.
How long has his childhood lasted as an adult?
Yeah,
like shouldn't his adult childhood be over?
Yeah, I wish my childhood lasted more than 12 years.
Yeah, the guy's 50 years old, for God's sake.
Huh?
He needs to get over it and go to the state theater. Out.
State theater. That's what Jimmy's playing.
Right. You know, there's so many kids that grow up and they do whatever. They're a musician, whatever. Yeah. They're not raping other kids.
Jerk off with each other in
you
bed.
Know, I missed my childhood. I had a good one.
You did?
No, it was fucking horrible.
Yeah. Ugh. You have, like, bad parenting or something?
Well, like, divorced parents, you know. Yeah. You're just doing shit to get attention. That's. I mean, I was fucking shooting.
All his friends were gay.
Playing roulette. in fourth grade, cutting school, stealing money.
My parents were
school.
Divorced. I didn't go on a tear like that with drugs and gambling.
I was breastfed with doorknobs.
Perfect Peter Laurie. Shut up, asshole. Trying to do Woody. Fuck yourself.
Well, Adam and George hating each other.
Adam and George
are
fighting a little bit.
Have you ever met a ventriloquist that got along with his dummy?
Very tricky relationship. They really don't like each other, but they depend on each other.
I had a great fucking story with Art Arnold back in the day. Remember when me and Frankie came over to your house, Bastille?
Oh, yeah.
Back in
Brighton Beach.
Yeah, this is when I was doing drugs. So I'm on fucking major fucking crack, and Frankie's on heroin, and Otto's just, like, drunk, so he lets us come over his house, right? So we're sitting there just all wired, and we're hungry, and Otto just has, like, one can of beans, and he cooks us beans. And
he puked. I remember that he was puking.
That was Frankie, because he was on heroin. Yeah. Frankie was on heroin. And then we're sitting there all wired, and Otto would nod out and then pop up and go, fuck Messina. Like, these are big people in the business. Remember?
Fuck Harry Grant.
Yeah. I remember we went to one spot where you were copping crack, and a guy comes out of a doorway, and he's firing a gun, and then you go, oh, that's my guy, and you walk towards the gunfire. No, it's cool. He knows me. As soon as that clip is empty, he's going to hook us up. I never saw a guy walk towards the gunfire. It was unlike the fucking Wild Bunch. That's a true story.
That is how important that crack was.
Oh, man,
right
he was
there.
Fearless. I'm telling
fuck
you.
It. Walk toward the gunfire.
Like that's my guy.
A
he's
lunatic.
Cool.
What a friggin' lunatic. That's my
amazing
guy.
Amazing that you lived. It's great.
That's my
hilarious
guy.
Yeah.
So who was he shooting at? Do you know?
Someone's trying to rip him off or something.
Firing.
He wasn't after me.
Yeah.
Wow.
Remember we took Keith Barony up there and said my sister lives?
Yeah.
I go, well, you're coming from a gig, me, Otto, and this guy, Keith. And I go, Barony. I got to stop at my sister's house.
Sister's house.
170th.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow, she's not doing well.
Yeah.
Holy all right, here we go. Geez, the Dove Lady. A lot of people are asking these people outside the courthouse if Michael Jackson, should stop sleeping with little boys.
Uh-huh.
I'm sure he doesn't need anybody's advice. I'm sure that Michael is not going to just go through this ever again. I'm sure he's just going to change his lifestyle and perhaps just stop helping people because
helping
it's causing
people.
Him nothing but pain.
And by helping, I mean fucking little boys in the ass.
No, he's going to start killing them.
Oh, there you go. That way they can't talk.
Isn't that the problem anymore?
I would have loved you years ago, but they've made it. I have to kill you. I got to choke the life out of you.
But you know what gets me? This bitch shows up with beards. Why is she the spokesperson for everybody in Michael Jackson? She's a fucking cunt with a birdcage.
Circus. Reverend Al Sharpton got involved with this at the end? They were interviewing him yesterday?
Well, he was supporting Michael during the time he was calling Tommy Mottola a racist. Remember that whole episode?
And the birds were flying out of his hair.
Mottola wasn't he banging, what's her name?
Mariah.
Mariah?
Yeah.
Mariah's half black.
You
can't be a racist and be having sex with black people.
Doesn't work.
Yeah, you can. It could be a fetish.
I don't think you're a good racist if you're having sex with the people that you're bad-mouthing.
But you know,
I don't know. A lot of those black leaders were doing just that. They had little...
That way it works.
What did I miss?
I'm talking if you're a white guy who can't stand black people, you're not going to be having sex with a black girl.
But it's like that whole Mandingo thing. Take it, you know, fucking...
Yeah?
Yeah, you play slave owner.
Yeah.
Play
hell
slave
up
owner.
In Harlem.
I could have you shot for that.
Well, what do you want to hear? We got Reverend Al Sharpton shows that he was innocent first, or do you want to hear, should he stop sleeping with boys?
You know we're going to hear both of them, so start with Reverend Al.
All right, we'll start with the first clip here from Reverend Al Sharpton.
I think that this is a vindication for people that believe that people are innocent until proven guilty. And I think that there are no winners here. I don't think there's no reason for Michael or those opposed to Michael to gloat. There's a lot of pain, a lot of hurt here. Yeah. Children have been dragged into court. Michael's reputation has been damaged severely. But I think the criminal justice system worked this time. I think we can say that this jury despite being inundated by media, despite the fact they were not sequestered, despite the fact there were questionable rulings by the judge, this jury said the evidence wasn't there and they acquitted him. I think this is good for America. And I don't think any of us that went on the line saying that Michael deserved the same right as any citizen
are
celebrating
Tawana
tonight.
Yeah.
Anything
just when he
other
tries
than
to sound
the
like
fact
this.
That people
bring up
should
Tawana
have
Brawley.
The right to be proven guilty of a crime, even if we disagree with their lifestyle.
Oh, what about you?
But you know what? They just didn't have the that piece of evidence that could tie everything together, unfortunately.
What, a jizz-stained, hairless ass?
Well, I'm...
What does he need? What do you need?
Yeah.
Do I think he's guilty? Of course. Yeah. But everything I read about the case, they just didn't have the DNA evidence or any piece of evidence that really was going
to,
you know...
Because he's good at this. He knows what he has to do to keep from being prosecuted.
Yeah.
He has these locked rooms.
He's probably going to get really good gifts for all the jurors. What is that cunt mother going to, you know, throw their way? She has nothing to offer them.
Right, right.
They're all starstruck in L.A. There's no crime. Murder's not a crime anymore. You know, Robert Blake.
Oh,
what's
he got away
crime
with it?
Out there?
Mm-hmm.
That Robert Blake thing's amazing. He's got to just shut his mouth. He got away with murder. Just go away now.
Yeah.
I was getting my gun from the restaurant, and when I came out, she was shot.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
What are the
Not
odds?
Guilty.
What are the odds?
I was in the restaurant. I was getting my baseball bat. I came out. She was bludgeoned about the head.
Yeah.
I was getting my knife at the restaurant. Yeah. She was stabbed to death. The guy, he's guilty. But, yeah, people get starstruck. I watched him. He was Beretta.
I know.
Not guilty. Not guilty. They have no way to convict these people out there.
But it's also reasonable doubt has become, like, it seems like the more you get DNA and stuff, the more reasonable doubt there becomes.
But also, the defense lawyers are so good at twisting that shit around to make it sound like it's nothing. The prosecution spells it out, but they're morons that go on juries. Come on, let's be real here. People that actually don't try to get out of jury duty are fucking retards. And they're sitting there, and now as a prosecution expert...
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
As a prosecution expert, you're supposed to sit there and explain DNA and all kinds of this CSI-type evidence to these people.
Yeah.
They don't get it.
Yeah, there's 1 in 1 million chance this is not the person.
Yeah,
well,
oh, there's a chance?
There's a difference.
As you heard him say, there is a chance.
It's absurd.
And relatively speaking, in the context of the universe, it's a huge chance. What?
And Sharpton says justice was served. What if he was guilty? What do you know, they jump on the bandwagon every time.
Yeah. Then it would have been, a grave injustice has been delivered to our brother Michael, who is still black under his fingernails.
Yeah, black people were probably upset that they couldn't, rise up and raid stores.
Oh, loot.
Little rioting.
Yeah. Why? But we don't get a TV.
Yeah, right? Can't we just riot a little bit? I'm kind of outraged a little at something. Can I riot and then give you my outrage reason later?
Yeah.
I want to, like, kind of a riot layaway plan where I get the merchandise now.
San Antonio beat Detroit. Let's riot.
Yeah, let's riot.
Live in L.A.
All right, more from Reverend Al Sharpton. Should he stop sleeping with boys?
I think that Michael now can have time to reflect and think a lot of deliberate moves as he goes forward. The question is, Jeffrey, that whether or not it was a crime for him to say that. Whatever my feelings, I... talk to Michael. I've been to Neverland, and I've had advice for Michael, pro and con. The issue here was not my advice as a minister or even as a man. The issue here was whether he committed a crime. That should be proven. Otherwise, it would set a precedent that anyone could make an accusation against any public figure.
Right,
and
kicking
we'd be
watermelon.
Brought into jail or convicted just based on media hysteria rather than hard evidence. That was frightening to me about the condition of this trial.
Soon I'm going up to heaven on the big river boat.
George.
Monkey. Arnold, looks like George doesn't like people of color.
George.
Nah.
You are a racist,
nice
George.
Sugar.
That will not be tolerated.
Gentlemen.
George, my God. I think you're living in the 1800s.
Yeah.
What's wrong with you?
Must have been carved from an old tree.
Yeah.
That's got to be it. An old riverboat.
ruining everything.
Oh, very good.
It's like my peppy told me.
I don't know. Do you want to hear from the DA or jury, the jury foreman?
Are they going to convict him?
Various jurors. One of them. Well, this might be interesting.
Is there going to be a federal case next, or it's going to?
They're going to do something where his civil rights. Usually, they go to a civil rights thing. Yeah. If you lose the criminal case, you violated their civil rights.
Yeah. Well, won't they sue a civil lawsuit? Like that's what happened.
Yeah,
OJ.
You could have the civil thing. Yeah, OJ was acquitted of killing her, but they.
They cleaned him out.
Yeah, they said that. Oh, they didn't clean him out, though.
They didn't.
They can't take any money out of his football pension, which
he's
is
in Florida,
all he's living
right?
on. Yeah, and that's Florida law.
And that's all he needs.
So he lives on that. He doesn't work. He goes out, hangs out with friggin' sluts at parties all night.
God, it's a sick world.
Yeah, it really is.
But they took his Heisman Trophy. Can you imagine having that around the house, his Heisman?
Like he cares. Like he even cares. He got away with murder.
But they couldn't take his money out of his bank account or...
No, they could.
His assets?
They could. I don't think he had anything really at that point. I think he had it all. You know.
Yeah. His lawyers took everything.
Spent on
the first
legal
case.
Fees.
Yeah.
And then,
what was left?
And then he gets what he gets from a pension. He's got a huge pension that comes in that they can't touch, and that's it. So he lives his life. He screws broads. Now though, he's like old. You don't realize how long ago that whole case was.
Yeah.
It's old OJ, and he can barely walk anymore.
Yeah.
So I guess these girls feel safe. You'd be chasing him with a knife and just kind of limping along all in slow motion. Screw you, OJ. Be fun to watch.
All right, we got what kind of mother lets her son sleep with men? One of the jurors.
As a parent, it's something that you are constantly, every moment of your day, you're protective over what happens to your children. And I guess I might be speaking maybe for myself and a few others, jurors, that, you know, what mother in her right mind would allow that to happen or you know, just freely volunteer your child, you know, to sleep with someone. And not just so much Michael Jackson, but any person for that matter. So that's something, you know, that mothers, I think, are naturally concerned with.
I'm glad they do. Me and Opie wouldn't have girlfriends if that was the case.
But the mother wasn't... Wow. The mother wasn't on trial. She's saying the mother. You know, that's what this fucking
right.
story. The
they
mother was not on
around.
Fucking trial.
Mm-hmm.
So the mother's wrong. The mother's wrong.
Yeah.
You know, it depends how you look at it.
Yeah. What's the worst sin, right?
But that's diverting attention to what the Michael Jackson.
The truth of the matter
did.
Is, the mother could have sent the kid there with every intention on extorting money from Michael Jackson. Hey, I'm going to send him there. Michael Jackson's going to sleep with him. I'm going to extort money out of him. It doesn't matter what her motives were. Try her for something else. The bottom line is he was with the son doing things he shouldn't have been doing.
Yeah, and that's the jury's
mindset.
And
if she tries to spin a buck out of it, that's her sick problem.
Yeah.
It doesn't make him innocent.
You notice how I pointed that out?
I noticed that, Rick.
Smart.
Very smart.
But it is interesting that all the in the papers and everything, they didn't like the mother. That is really what it comes down
to. You
see
the feisty 79-year-old woman?
Don't snap your
fingers. Don't. I was thinking, don't snap your fingers at me, lady. Stop it. Break a hip.
Yeah, for that kind of money, I'm sending my two daughters over in bikinis with fucking roofies. Put it in his drink. Turn on the tape recorder.
Wow. That are all cunts, including my mother and a Virgin Mary.
Wow, George.
Why?
Oh, are you inappropriate today, George? God, he is surly.
I've taken this freedom a little too far there, this satellite radio, where you could say anything.
My goodness, his cheeks are very rosy today. Potty mouth.
Yeah. Did Cedric play a good Ralph Cramden? I didn't see the movie.
I didn't see it. I just was angry that they even made it.
I know.
Come on. I wouldn't even want to see Gleason and Carney do a feature film. It was a great black and white TV show. It was a work of art. Leave it alone.
We're so with you. We were enraged when we first heard about it. And then to find out they barely... It shouldn't be called The Honeymooners at all because it had nothing to do, really, with the TV show.
Yeah, at all.
Did you see the later ones they made in the 60s with Meredith
singing?
McCray?
Yeah, they're singing. Yeah,
they're
no
singing,
good.
And it was in color, and it was... awful, like cringe. You can't even watch Gleason in this.
I don't like seeing great clowns get old, you know, like the later, like, Marx Brothers movies. I want to see them at that time when they were, you know, at
Three Stooges height. When they're all gray.
Yeah.
And they just look dangerous. It looks dangerous for them to be hitting each other.
Yeah.
with their graham cracker hips.
Well, everything is stolen. Kojak. Kojak. Look, Ving Rhames is a great actor. He doesn't have to, like, he sucks on a lollipop, that's going to sell the show.
Yeah. It's
just
nothing
make him a
to do with Kojak, right.
Just make
he's
him
got
a
shaved
detective.
Head, and he sucks on lollipops.
He doesn't even have a lollipop on the new show, does he?
I saw one episode where he had a lollipop.
Yeah.
I don't know if he had him in any of the other ones. I can't testify to that.
It's an original thought in Hollywood. Not only that, they're taking all the white classics and throwing the colors in them.
The colors?
I'm just saying. I'm not trying to be a racist. I'm, you know. Yeah.
Shouldn't you be on a fire hose somewhere releasing German shepherds? Colors?
Let's say hi to Matt on Long Island. Matt, what's up?
Hello?
Hey, Matt, go ahead.
How you doing? I got a problem with you guys here. The guys always say women comedians are not funny, but here Bonnie's in there, you guys are hooting and hollering like there's no tomorrow.
Yeah, but they're telling me what to say.
Yeah. She could be funny sitting here at a mic. I'm just saying women act,
you guys
their
do
acts
you,
aren't funny.
Promote that women aren't funny?
All the time.
Either
we're comics.
Or,
so do you.
You're not intimidated.
It's awful.
Not very smart.
We say very rarely they're funny, and Bonnie is one that is indeed funny.
Yeah, we've acknowledged that Bonnie's very funny. We have.
You've been there, and you guys just twisted all
crap.
Around there.
Oh, these callers got to fucking die. They just...
I like this
they're
one.
They're so full
I like
of
this
hate.
One.
Yeah, they are.
I know, they don't think they're just
they're looking
hateful.
For any excuse
Matt.
To turn on us,
Matt.
Is what they're doing.
Here's the reality. You got to do your own math. If we didn't think Bonnie was funny, she wouldn't be on a mic
that's
right
true.
Now.
You know what? She probably would have lasted about 2 minutes. She would have hustled her right out of there.
She would have stayed on that couch over there, like, yelling from the background.
She's topless. That's,
yeah, that's right.
Very good, that's, Bonnie. That's see, it. She's funny.
Yeah, she shows us her boobs from time to time, too. I mean,
hey,
I know what
that.
I got to do.
All right, you guys are great. I'm punching out.
She shows more skin than the average stripper that comes in here.
Yeah. Stupid stripper.
And she's
team
a
player.
Huh? She's
Joe
a team
Cartier.
Player.
And more bush.
Yeah, Otto, did you hear about that? We had
Joe Cotty, brings a stripper, he doesn't strip.
Right. There he is, right out there. That's his punishment. We don't even allow him in today.
Isn't that great? Strippers that don't strip. Yeah, all their other talents will cover for the fact that they're nude.
Just
morons come in here.
Yeah.
Morons with tits that they're not showing.
He brought strippers in that would do nothing.
Oh. Like, strippers
why are you
with
here,
a steam.
Then?
They whine.
Right.
You could beg regular girls to take their clothes off and be denied and feel like a piece of shit afterwards. I don't want a stripper to come in and have to, like, sit there and have them roll their eyes. They looked at each other. We were like, hey, why don't you take your tops off? And they looked at each other, the two strippers, and they'd roll their eyes like, oh, no, we don't want to do that. Why the fuck are you in here then? Why? Bring out the scrolls with the cure for AIDS on it.
Yeah.
Do as I command you.
I thought you meant furniture stripper. Who, this guy? What's his name?
Stripper.
Yeah. Okay, look how skinny this guy and how fat. They should be on an island in a Bugs Bunny cartoon, these two. Oh, we're going to have a rabbit. It's a fucking, like the number 10 sitting out there. Who is that guy right there, the skinny guy?
You didn't just do the number 10 joke, did you?
I stopped it because the other one was so funny.
You should have stopped at the other one. You killed with that, and then you went with the hack joke.
Didn't Martling do that on Star Search in like 86, and they were goofing on him for using that joke? Like then?
Kill it, just fine. You did really well, and then you had to go with they look like the number 10.
Here comes the vultures calling in. Fuck him, he stinks. Right. Motherfucker. Why do you get that slobbering bucktooth on there? What has he done in his career?
Already.
He sucks cock for money.
The Gregster, North Carolina. Voss, be funny just once. Please, just once.
At least 15 times today, but I fuck this internet.
Stop looking at the internet.
No, listen to
me. You don't like it, I know.
Ah, they're out of their mind. They come see me in clubs. I'm doing 2 hours. I say, well, we love them in clubs. You know what? Go fuck yourselves.
Yeah.
Buy the t-shirt. Voss sucks.
Strap her to the table.
Yeah, he's so bummed that he has a t-shirt out now that reads Voss sucks. That's how bummed
that's what
you
they
are.
Drove me to.
That's how bummed you really are.
I like after shows, though, like these women will come up and they're like, oh, don't you have something else? I think you're funny. Like they don't get it at all.
Oh, man.
No, I don't want to wear that.
That's because you can't fit it. You got to see my fan base. Oh, my God. Yeah. They're not dipping their arm in cheese and nibbling on it. They're ordering three pizzas.
Did we talk more about the Rolls Royce on eBay and all that?
No, I want to get to the bottom of how
because Bonnie's
we
here, too. We could get her perspective on this. Otto, have you heard about this?
He bought...
He tried to buy a Rolls Royce on eBay.
What year?
It was a 98.
A 98 Rolls.
I can understand wanting to drive a Rolls, though. You
know? No, it wasn't a 98.
You got to be driven around in a Rolls.
Yeah, yeah, you can't drive your own Rolls.
Yeah.
He said he was going to get Patrice to drive him around.
All his fantasy was he just kept having this fantasy of pulling up. I don't even know where, and all his friends would
pulling up in a Rolls, right, and your friends are seeing you.
What are you, Arthur?
Yeah, like, moving on up.
You're going to drive into the neighborhood in your Rolls Royce.
Once around the park, bitumen.
Just stand next
Where's
to
the rest of that moose?
Just stand next to the car waiting for people to notice.
I fell out of the car. Is that the funniest thing you've ever seen?
Perfect Peter Lorre.
You stop. This was a good-looking car. If you
on
go to
internet,
eBay,
it was
yeah,
stopped.
Because
and what happened
on the internet?
In real life, it didn't look good.
It broke down on the test drive. We were in the car with her. Ask her.
Were you there?
Yeah.
Bonnie was there
on the test drive.
I got in and it smelled like mildew. And I said to the guy, "Oh, it's got a funky smell." And he goes, "Oh, you know what that is?" He had some, like, you know.
Ukrainian accent.
Yeah. That is sauerkraut in the trunk. And he pulled over, and sure enough, he had, like, this huge box of sauerkraut in the trunk.
And he puts it in the trunk for a reason.
Yeah, he put it in case they ask, I'm going to have
Cause
the
ready Because the thing
answer.
Stinks.
Yeah.
And he's able to say now, because the sauerkraut's in the trunk, but why the fuck do you have sauerkraut?
Like, the car went off a pier at some point.
Yeah, that's probably what happened. It got flooded. Got soaked somehow. Fell into a lake.
And then he had kibasso or whatever. What's it called? Kibasi?
Kibasi?
Kibasso.
Kibasso. I don't know. What's it
Famous
called?
Famous sumo wrestler, kibasso.
I got to say sausage.
Say Polish sausage. Yeah.
Wow.
How does that work? Do you meet him, like, under a bridge with the car? I mean, does he bring it to you? Or?
Well, no.
Yeah,
I was in
his house.
I was working in Florida.
It was a car dealer shooting the gun. He knew it was this guy.
I know, this is my guy.
I was just looking on eBay at cars, and this one so happened to be in Fort Lauderdale, where I was going the next week.
Right. Mm.
So on eBay, it really looked clean. There's a link somewhere. Someone has it on.
It looked nice on eBay. Shiny, didn't look dented.
Beautiful, not dented. It looked like a nice... Have you seen it?
I saw the picture, yeah.
It's not a bad-looking car. I mean, if you had that car, you know, a little status...
Status.
You know what Keith Robinson said? He goes, "Does it come with a Tommy gun?"
Tommy gun, right on the
Bonnie and Voss,
right on the running boards. Bonnie and Voss. That's hilarious.
It smelled like Kielbasa.
Right. What the hell is Kielbasa?
Whatever. I don't eat red meat.
Oh my God, it's not red meat, really.
Oh, brother. So
it's everything but the red meat.
So now you saw it and figured you're going down there, but my God, this is such a good deal that someone's going to scoop it up before I get there, so I better put a deposit on.
Yes, because here's what it was.
I just say this? I said to him, don't do it many times. This is the first time I'm saying I told you so.
Ah, good.
But it was really, it was irritating.
Well, I'm just trying to understand.
Get used to that feeling of irritation.
More of this is coming your way when you say, I do.
I do. I'm irritated.
I'm just trying to get a second car for you. This wasn't really for me.
Yeah, and then he kept trying to say it was for me, this whole thing that he was
doing.
Don't
do me any favors.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. I see it on the internet, and I'm looking at it. It was like 26, right? And
26 large.
26, you know. So everything's excellent. I go to, it says everything's excellent. Then I go to, like, you know, not a blue book, you know, whatever, because they didn't have blue book for that year, that low. So, but it said 44,000
or
50,000 in mint condition.
You're
so
ahead
I'm going,
of the game right from the start.
Well, so I'm saying I'm going to take it home, drive it a couple months, and sell it, make like 15 grand.
Mm-hmm.
Turn it over.
Turn it over, but I've never done that before, so I, you know, it could have been it could have backfired.
Of course.
He was trying to get the deposit back. He kept saying to the guy on the phone, but I wanted to make money off of this car.
Oh, God.
That was his excuse.
That's an excuse?
That was like why he should get his money
back. And the guy's like, I did the same thing, and I made a grand already.
Yeah. But don't make it sound like, he got it from eBay. eBay is nothing but classifieds on the computer.
Except
that's all.
Except you don't put $1,000 down.
Well, I bought clothes off of eBay, some good stuff.
You
I bought golf clubs.
Why are you buying clothes off eBay?
Wait, how about just boughten?
Boughten.
Boughten?
Yeah,
I bought clothes off of eBay.
Whatever, okay, past boughten. Tense.
Okay.
Well, past tense. Here's the thing. You can get deals. Like, I've gotten, like, Prada pants for, like, you know, $70 or whatever for
Were
Prada.
Were they used?
No, brand new with the tags and everything.
How do you know they're not counterfeit?
Come on.
Well, this one, like, people aren't counterfeiting designer because, everything.
Well, yeah, that's true. Yeah. But here's the thing. There's certain ways to tell. Mm-hmm. Like the buttons.
Why would someone be selling them cheap? How would you legitimately be selling
them
cheap?
Because I bought golf clubs. I bought golf clubs because they don't. A golf shop is paying high rent overhead, and these places sell them out of a warehouse, where they just have boxes of it, so there's no overhead. That's cutting out the middleman. Okay,
Katie,
that's how
you explained
it
to me already.
Okay, I heard that. You knew the cutting out the middleman
so
thing,
that's
there, Bonnie.
Okay, you know, you got to know how to get deals. All right, you go to AA meetings, you find guys whose marriages aren't working, or you get a ring. Things happen. You got to know how to make them happen.
Get a bargain, right? So the Rolls is on there. You see it. It looks good online. You call the guy up.
Yeah.
And you say, I'm interested in the car.
Yeah.
I'm going to be coming down there to take a look at it. And what does he say? Well, there's another guy. There's another comic that's working down here, and he's ready to buy it. That old gag.
You're right.
I love The Wizard of Oz. I'll buy anything that has to do with that movie. And this guy on eBay was selling the Ruby slippers, and I bought him. It was Jack Ruby slippers.
Fucking hard. I like that one, Otto. George, did you like Otto's joke?
Yeah, it was about as funny as a cry for help. Fucking stink on hot ice.
All right, it was a mistake.
Call him up.
I call the guy up and I say, I'm interested in the car. He goes, well, you got to leave a deposit, you know, because
use his accent.
I don't do accents.
And Joe Conte doesn't do sit-ups.
So he wanted a deposit, even though you're coming down. How long between the time you talked to him on the phone till you were going to be down there looking at the car?
2 days.
2 days. So for 2 days, this guy wanted $1,000 to hold this car for you.
That's when I should have known something.
And
I'm a street guy. I know kind of scams.
You run into gunfire. I know. You're a street guy.
I was, what?
Well, he gets taken in by salesmen all the time.
Oh, no, you're that guy?
Yeah. We were in this Weiland gallery. You know, the guy who does those dumb fish paintings.
Around the country on the walls.
Yeah, he does them on the walls. He basically just put his, like a fish drawing on anything in his name and try to sell it. So we go into one of these galleries, and next thing you know, it's like hours of them putting stuff on the walls, turning the lights down so we can see it better.
I have no patience for any of that.
Rich just keeps going. He just keeps going. Can you send it to me? And how is this?
Wrap that up, please. I'll take two of these.
Oh,
please ship that to my palatial condo.
They hated me because I was like, get out of the store.
Well, listen, you're not social. You're antisocial. You don't like people. You don't fucking, you know, I like to talk and get a little knowledge.
You're a people person.
Well, I'm getting a little knowledge out there.
Wow.
The guy's a hack.
Are you talking to
painter.
Mongoloids?
Did the fish painting smell like sauerkraut?
What's that smell?
Good. You're one of those guys. What about on the phone? Is he always on the phone when they call up with telemarketers or... You try to conduct business, and they always try to rope you into something else?
No, those people I don't have patience for. So you can't
on the phone, I'm brutal on the phone. In real life, face-to-face, I'm pretty bad because I will sit there and listen to somebody's stupid pitch and want to smack them in the head, but I'm too much of a pussy to say anything. On the phone, last night one of the fans went out on my computer, so I had to call up Dell, and it was a big pain in the ass to try to get an actual person on the phone. So I get the person, and I want to order a new fan. So I say, I need a fan for this computer. And it turns into a whole thing. Have you heard about Dell's new incentive plan? And I just went, no, I want no incentive plan. I want this fan. I want it sent to me next day. That's it. That's all I'm calling you for is this fan. Okay, please hold. I hold. He goes, okay, we put that order in. Do you know Dell's preferred customer service will get you? And like he's got a script that he's got to read to everybody. Yeah. And I just lost it. I'm like, I just want the fan. Don't mention another thing. I over the phone, I'm brutal. But in real life, I'm like, oh, yeah, please tell me about this. I'm looking at my watch, kicking myself because I'm a faggot.
That guy's probably in India, too.
He was in India. He had a slight Indian accent. They're all in India now.
Yeah, they get taught to have a Texas accent. They take classes and stuff to... yeah, which I think is racist. We can't just do their accent.
They want, what do you want to defend, my friend? We will tell you one. Yeah, so they got to make it sound more American.
Yeah, they...
So we accept them.
So that we think that...
Yeah, that we're going to get what we need. Because I would be, oh, great. If I heard this guy, okay, your order is complete, it's going to be sent to you, I would hang up thinking, great, I'm going to get like a mouse sent to me or something. A real one, not even a computer one.
So to finish this up, how did you get your money back in the end?
He put it back in because I went on the radio. I was on the radio down there and I was trashing him and trashing the car.
Did he say his name or anything?
No, but I think he might have heard me and he knew that I was an entertainer and I could have, you know.
Yeah.
He gave me his business
card. He could have blown up his spot, God forbid.
No, he gave, what happened is he gave me his business
card. You'll ruin his credibility 30 people at a time.
I've seen the lines outside when you're giving free shit away, okay? Jesus Christ, there's three fat people and a stripper that won't get undressed.
when he's right, he's right.
Sure.
But he gave me his business card with his address and everything. That's what he went wrong. That's where he went wrong.
Oh.
You know, because now I got his, you know, whatever.
Now you got his address?
And this and that. So he puts him, and plus, also...
know where you live.
I'll call the state's attorney. You can't keep somebody's deposit. That's what I heard.
Squirt some sauerkraut on the welcome mat. You get back at him.
It was a mistake. I lived and learned.
All right. Yeah. We should take a break.
I don't believe you're gullible, though. You just want a car, and you hope that there's a deal somewhere, right?
Yeah. See, you know what I'm saying.
Maybe
yeah.
Try it again. Look for another
I'm looking
role.
At a BMW on there.
A
some
Beamer.
Nice BMWs
oh,
on,
look
the,
at you.
On
All
eBay.
Right, well, we'll see what happens with that.
good luck to you.
Good luck to you. Exactly. Huh? Oh, okay. Yeah, we should take a break. We went really long. In studio, Otto and George. He's got a new DVD out. Well, your first one, right, Otto?
Yeah.
Otto and George, Classic
I'll
Moments,
be at the
Montreal
Comedy Festival this July in the Nasty Show.
Very Otto, cool. Otto, what would you... Think we live together or something? Maybe you got another one of those I can take home with me? Like me and Opie. It's like the Beatles in Help. We all live together.
I've been watching bootleg Otto and George tapes for years, man, because you used to perform at Fast Eddie's Club.
Fast Eddie's in Huntington.
And they used to film you, and that tape has been just, I don't know, copied so many times you could barely tell it.
I find there's a limited amount of like quick clips online and stuff that I found, but nothing really, you know.
Oh, that's got everything but me, like, getting up early.
Oh, you got American Dummy on here, the whole thing? Or
yeah,
just,
the whole thing.
Your appearance or the whole movie?
No, the whole movie's on there.
Very cool. I love that movie.
And yeah.
A Christmas short I did, and then there's a terrible movie called Rules for Men I was in with Martling and Florentine. Real horrible piece of shit movie.
Very cool. Well, you got to get with Steve because we could sell a million of these for you. Online.
Really?
Yes, which definitely. Well, you're Steve's in the other room. We got him. But Otto and George hanging to the end of the show. We got Bonnie, we got Rich Voss, and more right after these messages.
I'm gonna go to a baseball game.
The very worst of the Opie and Anthony FU line.
I'd like to say after you to Pappy. His Greg and Tony show jingle got me thinking that Opie's the goddamn Zed and Anthony's the shopkeeper and Norton's the Gimp and you got Brad Pitt. With a handful of grease faking Angelina Jolie in the ass to the feet. And man, you gotta stop this.
I'd like to give a FU to Las Vegas. Lost $1,700 there. I want to give a big fuck you to Opie and Anthony and Jimmy for playing this stupid shit about the gravity. Who cares? It's stupid. It's a waste of my fucking time, you bunch of douchebag fuck.
I want to send a big FU to Jimmy Fallon for trying to sound like Mitch Hedberg all night on the MTV Music Awards or Movie Awards, whatever the fuck that garbage was. Mitch Hedberg was a true comic genius, just like our buddy little Jimmy there. And Jimmy Fallon's a piece of crap. He should get in that taxi, fucking drive at 90 miles an hour to a pole.
Yeah, I gave big fuck you to Matt, you asshole. Thanks for fucking me over in the long run, you bastard.
But I want to give a big fuck you to my landlord, because she's a bitch. And she charges too much rent. But she's kind of hot. I want to send an FU to Hourglasses. Because if there wasn't any fucking hourglasses, then fucking Steve couldn't say, like, sounds through the hourglass. That shit fucking pisses me off. Hourglasses, fuck you.
I want to send this fuck you out to Mancow.
you sellout, you loser, you sucker of corporate media cock. Fuck you, man, cow.
Fuck you is for Rich Voss. I gotta tell you something. Jim's gonna go to the top. He's a funny, funny man. He talks the truth all the time. So what? You know, he's always talking shit about black. Chris Rock talks shit about white. And he never fucking came to the bottom. Fuck you, Rich, you jealous fuck.
Fuck Voss and his wannabe ass.
Fuck you!
Call the Opie and Anthony FU line at 1-866-FU-LINE-1. 1-866-FU-LINE-1.
Well, fuck you very much.
If someone get in the back.
All right. Having a good time today. Rich Voss in studio. Bonnie, Otto, George.
Everyone left the studio and left me in here alone with George.
Yeah, I was telling Anthony that George is...
he was talking to me.
It's very very creepy.
Creepy. You ain't no flogging either.
Because Otto left and George was just sitting there.
Sitting in Otto's chair.
And... yeah, when Otto's not working, George still looks very, very real.
Yeah, with the unblinking eyes staring at, grinning at you.
There's something,
yeah.
Just grin.
There's something very handsome about George, the new puppet.
Ooh,
the
really?
New George is like has this handsomeness about him.
A little more handsome
I don't know
than
why
the old
I'm
George.
Saying that because I'm going to get smashed, but George, you're very handsome.
Striking lad. Oh, thank you.
Well, faggot.
Gotta watch your cornhole around a blonde one.
I remember when we used to work for Mike Austin?
Yeah.
He died.
He died?
Yeah.
You kidding?
Get out of here.
How did it happen?
He fucking didn't pay me one night. We were working.
Like, who is this guy?
This guy, Mike.
Oh, yeah. Didn't you grab his TV?
I took his TV.
Yeah.
Because we did a gig. And
you're a thug.
I was working in the hotel, and then he was kicked out of his house. He had all his shit in the hotel room, and we're at he doesn't pay. I go, well, I'm not leaving with nothing. I fucking took his TV. It lasted for 8-9 years. It was good TV.
What a parasite shyster he was,
wasn't
right?
He?
Yeah. I kind of liked him, even though he was fucking us every time we worked. Like, I used to do Club Binet, and he would get $500 to hire me. He goes, you want Otto and George? It's $500. Then he would call me, and he goes, I got a gig. It's $75 if you want to do it.
Oh,
and he would
man.
Keep, yeah, $4.25 for him, and I would get $75.
What a scumbag.
That fucking idiot fronted me like a eighth of Coke, and I owe him the money. I go back to his house. I go, look, I sold it on credit. Can I get another eighth? This fucking guy gave me a quarter ounce of Coke on credit. Ugh.
Something
I don't know
me.
How many shit gigs I did to work that off.
Oh, I was going to say, $40 you never gigs. Actually handed him money back, did you?
Never. Never.
No way.
Anthony, another death at Disney.
Oh, I saw this. Yeah, we were talking about it earlier.
This is one of our own ongoing things that, you know, this happens all the time. But the public doesn't really get to hear about it, really, because they're really good at covering this crap up.
Well, it gets into the news. But the people at the park,
that's
they
what I mean.
Really never know what's going on. The ride closes a little. They hose it down. They're back. The music's playing
what,
again.
Did they say what ride it was?
Was this Space Mountain? Not Space
no,
Mountain.
No, it's this new one at Epcot, Mission Space.
Oh, okay.
Now, this one is fucked up.
And then what they usually do with the ride, they just have a sign like, closed for maintenance.
Yeah. Closed for maintenance.
Meaning they got to get that big, huge hose out and hose it down, get rid of all the blood.
That's
pull
it.
A head out of the spoke.
Get their Disney Imagineers to imagine how they're going to get that head out of there.
The Vic Morrow tilt-a-whirl. Joy.
Joy. Maybe they have to you know, get a coat of paint on the ride. And, cover some stuff up.
What, a kid get flown out of there or something? Or?
No, this is a 4-year-old boy vacationing with his family died on Mission Space at Disney. Apparently, he passed out on the ride. And then they went, got the paramedics, and they were taking him to the hospital, and he died.
Oh, there was some lady letting doves out going, what kind of parents puts their kids on rides?
Yeah. Mission Space visitors report that the ride is intense. It simulates a rocket blast off. Air sickness bags are provided for the visitors, just like Voss's act. A little air sickness bag.
Who would go on a ride that you, they give you air sickness bags?
Well, this one is...
four-year-old on that?
Yeah, now bring in your four-year-old on this. This just goes to show you people really don't understand these rides, especially the newer ones that go on, these simulations and stuff. You could get into one of these little boxes, and they show a movie on the front of the box, and then it tilts and kind of gives you this illusion that you're moving.
Rides, man. They
have one
so
called
sick.
Star Tours,
yeah,
and the Back to the Future ride is another one.
Okay.
And
one
they're pretty cool. I like the Back to the Future ride. That's wild. You really get the this whole... You feel like you're flying in this vehicle.
But you don't go anywhere. You're not,
you don't. You're up on what amounts to stilts in this thing, hydraulics, and it throws you around.
Yeah.
And if the screen makes it look like you're turning right, they'll tilt the car so you feel like G's pulling you to one side. It's a pretty cool idea. Well, this one, they put you in this Mission Space thing, and it works on a centrifuge. So you're in this thing. You're looking at this image, again, this simulation film playing in front of you. And when you lift off, this thing starts spinning, and you feel the G's now pushing you back.
Mm-hmm.
It's like pressure on your chest, your head, and you're pushed into the seat backwards. I don't know how safe that is for certain people. Maybe if you've got a heart problem, a brain problem, or if you're a four-year-old child with growing organs,
well, there's
perhaps
a,
you shouldn't...
No concept of what's going on.
Yeah, there's a height requirement of 44 inches.
On Michael's lap, he doesn't even have to push. He just squeezes right on it.
Close the park today.
Yeah,
yeah, and there's a height requirement. The kid made the height requirement, but he's four.
And then you get a Snoopy toe tag.
Oh, my God, Otto.
Oh, my God.
You think they got those at the morgue?
Yeah, you should.
Little colorful Snoopy toe tag for his little toe.
I got to tell you.
Snoopy's not a Disney character.
That's okay. The hospital isn't Disney. Little kid.
I got to tell you, George usually kills on this program, but today it's Otto killing.
Yeah, killing.
Otto's God killing damn. George, making you look silly.
Like Mission Space.
Dan Rowan, but less dead.
Oh, that's awful.
I'll never go on a fast ride again. When I was a kid, I went up, my mother put me on one, and I threw up spaghetti on everybody. And it didn't even look like it was chewed. That's how it came out, like big. Just spaghetti was flying all over me and the people behind me.
Oh,
just
God.
Ruining their little day at the beach.
Ruining everything.
My mother screaming, stop the ride. Fucking spaghetti.
What were you in, a teacup?
Projectile
vomiting.
No, bumper cars.
Teacup rides. I don't go on anything that spins around, nothing that goes upside down, none of that shit.
Fuck that.
I like, the most thrill I want on a ride is like, it's a small world.
Mm-hmm.
Sit in the boat, look at the little dummies, no offense. Kind of looks like him from the It's a Small World ride. Oh, is that it?
I have a profile on a condom tip.
There's nothing wrong with this. You sit in the boat, ride starts. 55 minutes later, you come out the other end after listening to this song.
Screaming.
20
make it
times.
Stop. Make it stop.
Turn it off.
In every, they do it in every language is what they do.
Yeah, and then you go around and there's little Japanese puppets. Boing, chang, 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 dang, chang, dang. Little Al-Qaeda puppets slowly sawing off other children's heads.
Great.
It's wonderful. Awful ride.
Oh, did you hear about that black guy's leg landing in the house in Queens?
He
must have had a riot with that thing, right?
Oh, of course. The African. He was, this guy decided he was going to stow away in a jetliner from Africa to New York. And apparently he got in the works because when the landing gear doors opened over Long Island, parts of his body came spilling out of the wheel well.
A frozen black leg and an Adidas sneaker landed on the roof.
It had an Adidas sneaker. It wasn't just his leg. It was part of his leg, his hip, and a little bit of his torso with a piece of a spine. And it crashed through this woman's garage roof and then fell on the lawn. And she heard a big bang, went out there, and there was a leg with a sneaker perfectly tied on it.
Who gets the miles?
That is some cleanup. Oh. But they said when the plane did land, they figured it out that it came from that plane. And then there was a delay, and they wouldn't tell the passengers. They just said, it's delayed for maintenance, while he hosed the black guy out of the wheel well.
He was dead.
You don't get a leg and half your spine and then go, okay, can I get my connecting flight? I'm going to Pittsburgh. What the hell do you think? The guy's... Yeah, where's my standard baggage claim? Where's my leg? We always lose my leg. Guy's dead.
Yes, he's
guy
dead.
Was dead when they left the runway.
Yeah. Dead, dead, dead.
Squeezed up in the gears.
And we left.
That's great. Some guy's dead.
There's no security. How do you just walk into a place and climb into a... Like, when we went to Amsterdam last week, they don't check anything. You just walk in. They look at your...
It's Africa. You ride a zebra up to the wheel and you jump in. What the hell kind of airport is in Africa? It's not like JFK.
No.
You find out where your baggage thing is by listening to drums. Oh, 25? Oh, I take this one down? Please.
Jesus.
Squirt some sauerkraut in the boarding pass.
Yeah, exactly. You and your sauerkraut for your... What was it? Kielbasa?
Kielbasa, whatever.
Kielbasa.
She's great kielbasa.
That's the guy's name that fell out of the wheel well. Kielbasa. Kielbasa. Man. Falls out. We are jaded as Americans, though, flying around. You know, oh, that airport. You think other countries' airports are going to be like that.
Yeah.
You land in some of these places in the Bahamas, and it's just a shithole with a strip of tar. And you get out, and you think, you know, where's the... You know, where's the moving sidewalk thing to the baggage claim?
Yeah.
Baggage claim. It's a pile. It looks like wreckage. Looks like the plane crashed, and you're picking through the wreckage
to
for your
find
suitcase.
Your suitcase.
Find your freaking suitcase.
They just toss
I was
it.
First class. Do I have the preferred tag on my baggage? Shut up. You're lucky we don't kill you. See the guy with the bone in his nose. Perhaps he can help you. That's how you feel down there. So just keep quiet till we get to the resort. I don't want to die here.
You're so... Right. They just pile it up.
It's a pile of luggage.
Just tossing it into a big pile.
Yeah, we might get booked in South Africa, though, working
on
that.
Oh, great.
To work...
You play in Sun City, man? What about apartheid?
No, I don't... It's not Sun City. It's
no, that was years ago.
But I can't wait to do my Rachel stuff in South Africa.
Yeah, it was great. It
Rachel?
Was...
What? Rachel. You got Rachel stuff?
Rachel, whatever.
Oh, Rachel? Like, talking to a Windex bottle.
It was great watching him do stand-up in Holland, because, like, you know, he's bringing racism to the Netherlands.
Yeah, there's how do you do gigs in another country? Aren't you afraid they just won't get
it? Well, everyone else in the world is so much smarter than we are. Like, they could watch a Dutch comic, and then they could watch, like, an English comic until they get it. Like, I couldn't understand the Scottish comic. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like,
no, Americans just want Americans or Yakov Smirnoff, who was a genius that was so underestimated.
We were doing shows there. It would be, like, four Americans. And the Dutch people would watch... But if you any comedy club here, if you put four guys from England on in a row,
it'd be a riot.
But I was up on stage trashing Arabs and it's all Moroccans in Amsterdam.
Are they?
Yeah, and I'm going out how everybody
funny, my
stinks
friend.
And Holland is the biggest scam when it comes to tourism. You know, what a marketing genius is. You know, come over and get wooden shoes and windmills and tulips, and it's fucking hookers and drug addicts. You know? You get there, where are the tulips? Where's the windmills? Yeah, right there. Go get high and shut up and ride your bike out of here.
Well, what is it, like an improv there or like a...
It was a festival. There was like, I don't know, nine comics from... God. You know, I don't know. There's a couple from Canada and the rest were from the States.
Then they had one little thing outside, a car.
It was a club, like a nightclub.
Volkswagen sponsored it. So you could sit in a driver's seat and two people would sit in a passenger seat and you had to make them laugh, do stand up in the car. And I would
Oh, my God.
So, and
they go, did you try to put a bid in on the Volkswagen?
I said,
that's good. It doesn't smell like sauerkraut sold.
But I did it. They go, will you do it? I go, yeah. And I'm in there with the two girls and, you know, how many times you get. But I had to run because I had a show in a van coming up. You know, God, I was so fucking strong earlier. Why don't I just shut up?
I noticed you were really, like, yeah.
I thought it was a real story.
It is a real story. Yeah.
No, but you know what he was doing? He knew he had a good show in that car, so he was trying to recreate.
Recreate it, and it just didn't work.
You can't recreate that moment.
Wow.
Wow, thank you for teaching me comedy story. And radio. Fucking been on the road an hour, and all of a sudden she's... Freddie Roman.
Story fell apart like an African in a landing gear. What happened?
All right. We could do a little something here, Anthony.
What you got?
I got Sue Johansson. We haven't done her
in a while. The old broad.
We got some witty people in front of us today, so we could...
Is she the sex therapist?
Yeah.
The grandma?
Have you heard
grandmother?
She's Canadian.
Yeah, obviously.
Do you like her?
She's...
We can't stand her.
I've never really seen her show.
She's sassy.
I've just seen very, like, small bits of it. But she's very pragmatic about the whole thing, right?
Yeah, she sits there. She takes calls. People have sex problems. She gives advice in a grandmotherly way,
right.
But it's pretty graphic
oh,
sexual
she on
advice.
TV?
Yeah, yeah.
I've seen her.
You've
yeah.
seen her?
Yeah.
Lifetime.
What does pragmatic mean?
Down to earth.
Oh. Is that the old lady we watched that one night?
Is she the one that was...
She looks like a nun or something.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
By the way, no one knew what pragmatic was in this room, but we all made believe except you.
Well, because I got to go home and listen to that kind of shit.
You use big words like that in front of Rich?
No.
Make him all nervous?
Sometimes I do. Like, if I get mad, I'll just start using
You should start making them up.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, it's very Will Elford. You know, and just, like, be like, yeah, what does that mean, honey? And then tell him it so he uses it in public and gets it wrong anyway.
When we first met, she was giving me the word of the day.
With you, it start with the, was.
After 3 days, cat. I go, I can't cat. Handle this.
I quit on 2 days earlier. I need to be
plethora.
Like,
you just give me a couple of weeks.
Plethora, you really?
Plethora.
Plethora.
Yeah. Oh, what's plethora?
A lot. A
Rich
lot.
Makes a plethora of mistakes.
He had a plethora of whack-off partners.
Very good.
All right, well.
Oh, gosh, he's way funnier than Sarah.
Oh.
Problem with Sarah Silverman?
Not at all. Good friend.
No.
We've had her on. She did.
She has one of the best openings in a movie ever. That goddamn one where she just gets punched in the face.
I never saw that.
That's God a great movie,
damn,
too.
Is that good? I know. I can't remember the name. Hey, oh. Derek's got his little sign.
What's the name of that movie?
He's like the little mute boy on Little House on the Prairie. He's just got to write things down. You got it?
It's Way of the Gun.
Yeah.
Way of the Gun. That was it.
Yep.
Yeah.
She gets laid out to start the movie?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
She's sitting on one of the guy's cars. Guy comes over and goes, you know, could you get off my car? And she just starts mouthing off.
Yeah, she calls him a baby fucker. And
yeah.
Yeah, you like to fuck little boys and stuff like that.
And then he's turned around and said to the guy that she was with, your girlfriend's a real cunt. And then she starts mouthing off and one of the guys just whips around and punches her right in the face, lays her out. Way of the Gun. Gotta rent that one
then
again.
Then she wakes up and she's going out with a talk show host.
Ooh. Who's she going out with?
Jimmy Kimmel.
Well, you make it sound like she doesn't go out with a lot of guys.
I'm just joking.
There's
she's
been a few.
Fucking funny, and he's a good guy.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Sue Johansson, the grandma, giving sex advice on the Lifetime channel. Mm-hmm. Here she talks about how it's hard to swallow, I guess.
Again? Or a different one?
No, this is a different one.
She always talking about jizz and how you're not supposed to
swallow
it. Oh,
this one's about improving the taste of semen. That's what you want to hear a grandma talk about.
Do a lot of drugs before you...
I find it really disgusting. Is there anything that he can do to make it taste better or that I can do?
Yeah, give up meat.
Give up meat?
Meat. Vegetarians, vegans, who only eat fruits and vegetables,
vegans, Rich.
Their ejaculate is sweet and nut-like. Whereas
nut-like.
Males who
it's
eat
all
meat,
nut-like, lady.
Their ejaculate tastes bitter like burnt leather.
Okay,
so tell him if he wants you to swallow, he's got to give up meat.
Burnt leather.
Okay, thank you.
Otherwise, you're
Rogers.
Not going to do it.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, bye. Julie.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Well, vegans have a sweeter jizz. Isn't that something?
For me to get her to swallow, I tell her she's co-headlining.
Snoopy's not a Disney character. Shut up, Ed.
I can't believe it took that long, because the minute it came out of my mouth, I was like...
George's.
I couldn't help.
Very angry
wow.
this morning.
More
angry than usual.
Yeah. All right. Well, you learned something new there. Don't eat meat. It'll taste like burnt leather.
Here she talks about bondage.
Does she know this from experience?
I don't know.
Because anytime she gives sex advice, you just picture this old broad on her knees just huffing. Oh, it's like burnt leather back in the 30s. You know, that's playing in the background. Hubba, hubba, you're quite a broad.
Why did Voss have to run out of the studio?
He got a phone call.
Oh, could be something important.
You'll tell us later?
No, it's not. So it was Gideon.
It wasn't Paris Hilton, was it? That's what we got last time someone had to take a phone call in the studio.
Paris Hilton called here?
He called
called someone that was on the air
the guys
with us.
From the singer from Corrosion of Conformity.
Yeah.
Wow.
Called up.
I'm wondering if you made that up, though.
Got a picture of her on the phone.
That's true. All right, here's the old grandma talking about bondage.
Relationship.
Oh. How do you feel about a little bit of a whipping?
A little nervous, I guess.
I bet you. You've never talked about this before. It just came out of the blue.
After 4 years of going out.
And all of a sudden she said that she'd like to. Now, does she want to start off by tying you up?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Handcuffs.
Handcuffs. Behind your back.
Yep.
Hands to ankles.
No, to the bed.
She's a Mountie.
What kind of handcuffs?
Yeah, Mountie handcuffs. What other kind you get up there, eh? Let me tell you, you know. Yeah, so I'm thinking maybe we ought to, you know, use the cuffs. Because that's what I'm all about. Shut up.
Think they were
Canadians.
You think they were the real handcuffs or the plastic ones where you have to be like, I'm
cuffed.
I'm cuffed. Oh. Do what you will.
She tickles you. You can break them and punch her in the face. Knock it off.
Bed. Why don't you try make a deal with her? In the beginning, rather than handcuffs, because handcuffs are scary. They're metal, and wow. You're really locked in there. It's just the idea that you're really locked in there. How about she just ties you up with an old silk scarf or a nylon pantyhose? Yeah. There's got to be some use for old runs.
I could choke her with it later.
Runny nylon pantyhose. Tie you up. Just tie you up.
Well, I just watched the show 8mm last night, eh?
Hey. that is a movie, too.
Great.
Slow down, buddy.
Oh, great. He's bringing up Nicolas Cage movies.
Right. Yeah. Slow
wonderful.
Down.
I just watched 8mm, eh?
That's a twisted movie.
And yeah, that was a sexy movie, you know? I'm thinking of killing people and putting it on film, eh?
Tool. Could have been a great movie if it wasn't Nicolas Cage in it.
Have you seen that yet?
No.
It's all about that kind of stuff.
And how did you feel? How did you feel while you were watching it?
I'm a little very scared.
Okay.
Very
scared.
Do you
trust your girlfriend?
Yes, I trust her.
Would she hurt you?
I don't think so.
Okay.
I don't think so.
Can you tell her that you're scared?
Yeah, I did, and she got a little upset.
Well, why did she get upset? What did she say?
Because she wants to do this badly.
Okay. But I think she should understand that you don't want to do it badly.
Granny's out of her league.
Yeah. Yeah. You're badly scared.
She's definitely in over her head on this one.
Now, the other concern is that you don't know if she goes from tying you up and handcuffs, that what else is she going to want to do?
Oh, they're going
to tell you. Yeah.
Bring in a black guy and have sex with him in front of you after you're chained to the bed. Hey, I'm into
it. Because it's not going to work. Not attracted to that, Manny. If you're very scared and this is something that you just can't, then the relationship in all probability will end because it's, you know, it's going nowhere. It's not going to work out between the two of you. Okay, thanks very much for your call. Hope we can solve that one a little bit.
She had nothing on that.
You had nothing.
She could tell how to diddle or how to, like, you know, suck a dick, but when it comes to a little bondage, she's lost.
All right,
I remember on the plantation, we used to have a little bondage.
Well, let's
hobble our Negroes.
Let's get the plugs in before we run out of show. Otto and George, want to thank you guys for coming by today.
Thank you, guys.
Absolutely. Very fun today.
Thank you.
Any gigs you want to plug there?
Double cock.
No.
Where am I? Medford, Long Island, exit, what is that, 64?
The governor's out there. Yeah, exit 64.
Are you going to Governor's in Medford?
No, it's...
it's not Governor's.
Comfort Inn, what is that? What? Hello?
Boss, real fast.
Laughter Hours in Centerville, Virginia. Me and Bonnie. This
Laughter
weekend.
Hours. It's almost like After Hours, but the laugh
I didn't
in front
fucking
of it.
Write the
5 seconds, Otto, fast.
Gateway Comedy Club in the Comfort Inn in Medford, Long Island.
Perfect.